Next game we're going to talk about is from the NFL with Al McMorty. KC against Pittsburgh, of course. Al McMorty gave us the Browns +4 last week. That was a winner. It was, a lot of turnovers for the Steelers in that game. It was kind of a game where everything just wasn't going their way. Now they're giving, though, a bunch of points to KC. You know, the defense is depleted, obviously, but there's some serious weapons on offense. How reliable is Mahomes going to be going forward to give that kind of performance game in and game out? I'm not sure, but week one certainly looked very, very impressive for KC as far as their offense is concerned. What's your take on Pittsburgh as a favorite here, Al?
Well, I want to go against Kansas City on the road as, you know, they're coming off that huge upset division win, which is key. And AFC West teams going all the way back to 1980, those teams have cashed just 34% off an upset division win if they're not playing a non-division foe on the road. So that's a big reason why I want to go against the Chiefs here. Throw in the fact that these two teams have met three times over the past two seasons. Pittsburgh has won all three games, both straight up and against the spread. And then, as you mentioned, you know, Pittsburgh struggled in its division game against Cleveland last week. And the Steelers are now 21-6 ATS at home off a division game where it was favored but did not win. So I'm going to lay the points with Pittsburgh.
All right. Historically, of course, Pittsburgh has pretty much owned the Chiefs, but maybe, you know, with a new offensive scheme here, this is a little bit of a different Chiefs team that has struggled against the Steelers in recent years. Ian Cameron, what do you think? Do you think the Steelers bounce back in a big way here?
It's to me, I'd lean KC, but there's something I like more in this game, and that's the over at 52.5. I think we see points. I got 50. I hate giving out a number that's two and a half points worse than what I got, but I have to. I think there's still a little value. I could see 31-24, something like that in this game where both teams can even hit the 30s. I think Pittsburgh's defense is going to struggle against Kansas City. The Tyreek Hill in open space was a monster for the Chiefs offense last week against the LA Chargers. I've still got major question marks about this Pittsburgh team on the defensive side of the football, but on the flip side, I have even more concerns about Kansas City defensively. This Kansas City defense, I ripped on them all preseason. I think I said they were going to struggle. Eric Berry being out last week even hurt them even more. The Chargers stubbed their toe. If they don't, you know, fumble the ball and miss field goals and that, they could add points against that Kansas City team. I have nothing to like right now about this Kansas City defense. They look porous. They were bad in preseason. They were bad last week. I think Ben Roethlisberger, James Conner, Antonio Brown and that offense is going to be able to exploit them big time. So I see a shootout happening here in the Steel City. We'll look over 52.5.
Mm-hmm. You want to make that one official pick, Ian?
Official, absolutely.
Wow, over 52.5. Yeah, I mean, I listened to your breakdown of the Chargers game last week where you liked the Chargers and the over, and I did tell you, but as I said, I was like, I'm just going to combine your analysis and take the Chargers team total over, which did cash, and you think that despite the huge total here of 52.5, that this game still has some value on the over. Of course, it opened at 49.5. Anyone who grabbed that opening line, congratulations. It's now 52.5 or 53. Al McMorty, historically, I know a lot of times you have apparently contrarian plays on totals that have over or under written all over them. A lot of times you're going the opposite way. And whenever you have an analysis where you're going the opposite way of an apparently obvious totals play, that is something that I'm likely to blindly tail. Those are some of the strongest plays I've ever heard you break down, Al McMorty. What's your take on this one, though? 52.5 or 53?
Well, this one certainly isn't a play, as you just described. If the total was sitting at 45 or 44, then yeah, but it's 52.5. So it certainly doesn't look easy, you know, to take the over in this ballgame. I'm going to stay away from the total. I actually did like a lot of what Ian had to say. I'm always going to call them San Diego. The Chargers last week, you know, they did leave a lot of points, you know, on the board. They could have gotten a lot more against Kansas City. Kansas City's defense leaves a lot to be desired. Pittsburgh, of course, their defense is going to get scored on by Kansas City. I can see it going over the total as well.
Okay. Sounds good. Ian Cameron's going to take the over 52.5 at -110 as an official pick. That is a market line right now. And Al's line for Pittsburgh is going to be -4, -102. There has been some money, initial money coming in on KC, which I guess is understandable considering how good they looked offensively last week. We'll see if this line creeps back up to 5 by kickoff. But as of right now, -4, -102 is the line for Pittsburgh. Again, Al McMorty's website is BigAl.com.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to our channel. Now we've put a lot of work into producing all these free videos, so please help us out and keep all our content free for you forever by simply liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Now, not to mention, a visit to our industry-leading website will warm the hearts of all our SBR employees, especially myself. Now, the links are over there to the left, so do check those out. Thanks for watching.